Nope. It's currently 7:15, and you can kind of see the sun trying to peek out.
I guess pools aren't open yet.
Ooh, pirate ship.
I think that's Tower of Terror. Nice.
Good morning, everyone. This is Jack, and welcome back to my channel. Today is day one, officially, of our trip to Orlando. As you can see, we are at the resort. It's not a bedhead. I got probably 5.5 hours of sleep, but we're ready and dressed like safari people because we're headed to Animal Kingdom. They're so cute! They look like bears.
Yeah.
Is you a scrub mommy?
I think I didn't plan for this one.
I planned mine too, girl.
I do have to say that all of the Uber rides that we took were the most pleasant I've ever had in any country ever because all the drivers wanted to be there and loved taking visitors to the parks.
Yeah, I like it.
A wild place to eat. Depends on what side you're on sometimes.
Oh, ducks. My friend Anna and I took 4 hours to plan our entire trip, and it started out with the Avatar flight ride. Since it is a newer addition to the park, a lot of people still want to go on it, and so we opted to get in line for that before the sun was directly above us and too hot.
I don't know, but it was very beautiful. Me eating, human eating sense. Eat all the children. Just kidding.
It really looks like you're on another planet.
I haven't seen the second Avatar, but I was able to go to a Lucasfilm exhibition that had all of the concept art and the backstory of the technology from how they made the first movie many, many years ago. And I do have to say they did an amazing job with the environment of this location. It really does feel like you are there. Luckily, Disney designed the first part of the line to be outside, and so when you've been in the line for over 30 minutes, you are able to relax in covered AC, which was really nice. The inside had a lot of dark areas that had black light splotches on them, and everything was pretty detailed along the way to the ride, including this science lab. So, Avatar Flight of Passage is a ride that you literally straddle the mechanism and lean forward, not unlike a motorcycle, and it's supposed to simulate being on a winged mountain banshee while taking in 3D flights over Pandora, which is the world that the Avatar live in. Bonding with a banshee is a crucial step in the life of the Na'vi hunters, and you are only able to fly on the back of one of these powerful creatures after earning the rite of passage. The rocky structures outside of this ride is called the Valley of Moara, and it's kind of like a floating mountain with glowing fauna and flora all over.
More science!
To get you ready and prepped to get onto the ride, they actually scan your face as you wait in line, and then you are paired with an avatar, and those that don't make the pairing have to redo it, and everybody is accepted, and then you put your items to the side and then go on your adventure.
Okay, on the way.
Do we have an idea of where the other one is?
like any great Disney ride, it always leaves you with wanting more in the gift shop. Also, we tried to go on the Navi River Journey ride, but either it closed or it was such a long wait that we ended up going to the continent of Africa in order to do the Kilimanjaro Safari.
That's because they ate lunch, so in their food coma.
That's so good.
Each of the safaris has a Jeep bus that has open windows, and then you set off in a guided tour of literally a lush African savanna and spot real animals that get to roam free in this area. This is called the Harambe Wildlife Reserve, and it's home to over 30 species living in 110 acres of picturesque open plains, shady forest landscapes, and rocky wetlands. It's about a 20-minute expedition, and you never know which animals you get to see.
Check out these animals, though.
As they weren't discovered until 1901 by the Western world, it's because they like to hide in the deep recesses of the forest. And whenever they were ever spotted, people usually only ever saw them by their rear end or legs, making a lot of them believe that they were 5 feet tall at the shoulder and have an incredible wingspan of around 9. Why?
We aren't going to see this large water hole. Now that he's watering, we'll also have to check some more of our friends coming by.
Tell she's a female face and the fact that she has no horns. As only the male greater crudo grow horns, while females will not. Abongos, they're kind of the yang to the yin of the greater kudu, as they like to blend in with the darker aspects of the
Oh, there you go. Those are good.
Now, in the event these animals do get spotted, they have their spiraled horns that they can keep. So they're pretty well adept at being down below. Bears have their eyes and nose facing upward on their heads. This will also come to the surface. Life. It gets this title for its ability to hold large quantities of water inside of its trunk and root system. This water can be very particular about what areas we're trying to look at. And they no longer get water during the dry seasons of Africa. Up together. Just like bird. Can't just be pushed off the summer view. This is the big horn game. Closely at their spots, and notice why they are the Maasai giraffes. As Maasai's, their spots are different. With this here to our side, you can see the springbok. Now, springbok, they're gonna get their name of each of 6 feet high in rapid succession, kind of being a pogo stick. And they can travel up to 13 feet. Now, they usually make those travels in larger zones involved. But unfortunately, you are not left. The largest species among the world. All females, they only go around 30 pounds. Well, they're going to start to their size cuts, but they usually that beautiful red glacier on their face. And also a great way to help the animals. As now, instead of taking aggressive action, we taught farmers to stay for beehive and supposed to their farmers. Elephants safe, the crops safe, the farmers happy. We'll also get handy with these two right here are two males, and they are doing a little bit of what we call jousting. That's something they'll do as a form of play. These are herds are supposed to be a and water. Off the other hand, she shoot herself one or two once, though she was a baby. Now then, here to the side, those are the their skin can burn two levels of skin disease and skin cancers.
One blocking the truck so the other one can eat the
yacht. Those cheetahs, they have been known to get to eat. Internally, I will sleep for around 16 to 20 hours on the day. I know. towards those eyes at night. To work through this. Yeah.
Such a relaxing and educational ride. I also really enjoyed the fact that a lot of the kiosks in Africa were actually from different tribes and countries in the continent. Also, can we just appreciate the designs of each of these kiosks? They're so elaborate, just to sell some drinks or snacks.
Yeah, I'm so used to like the Magic Kingdom scale that I'm just like, oh man, it's gonna take us 20 minutes to get over there.
Next, it was time to get some food. We stopped at Nomad Lounge, which is honestly one of my favorite park dining experiences. It's a refreshing oasis that's right on the river with specialty cocktails and enticing appetizers from all across the globe. It has African, Asian, and Latin fusion cuisines on the menu, and it's located right next to Tiffin's restaurant. It has beautiful compass, navigational decor, and flags hanging from the ceiling, as well as outdoor seating.
Cheersy!
It's like tracks.
And footprints.
And that's, I think,
I love the fruits too. Okay, so we got seated. We got a piece of brunch.
Really good.
Right, that's the second. He's like, getting more cocktail.
No, yeah, I'm taking a photo of my drink because I really like it.
Hey.
Hey,
shove back.
Guys. Bread's underneath. Coconut curry, guava, and a spiced ginger pear chip.
Bao chi keiju.
You want another
thing? We can put it here.
What other
drinks? Everyone's peachy right now.
Yeah. Okay, bye.
Of course, I had to check out the restroom and also use it, so here's a selfie. As customary to my channel.
It's all animals. Cool trash can. So cute. Oh, man. It's so cute.
The full Discovery series.
Wait, can I ask the brand?
There you go.
Cool. Bombs away. Ooh, they got Wi-Fi.
Next up, we were just in time for the Lion King show, and it is a little bit of a summary of all of the favorite songs from the soundtrack of the film, and the costumes were awesome, the floats were amazing. I didn't even know what to expect, but I was just along there for the ride. When I was 5 years old, I believe I had a Lion King birthday party that was huge in the Philippines, but yeah, that was quite a memory for being a Leo.
Leader of our group. Kiume is Swahili for masculine and strong. What do you think?
Florida, he's gonna show us his best lion imitation. Great job! Now let's hear your roar! 1, 2, 3!
Each performer had their own type of animal costume, and it was just so well done and apparent which type of creature they were. I actually got to see Lion King on Broadway almost 8 years ago, and it was a magical experience. It wasn't as joyful as this and the film, but it had its own artistry, and it kind of just gave me a little bit of nostalgia, reminiscing how often the Lion King comes back into my life.
Backside.
After that, we were able to go back to Pandora to go on the River Journey ride.
This looks like the drink we had. The Lotus one. Oh, really? I thought she said this is
Every time I come back to the parks, the animatronics just get so much smoother and so lifelike, it's kind of scary. All right, time for a drink.
I've just want footage of this.
This is the Tree of Life, and usually right at sunset before the park closes, because it closes early at 6 p.m., there usually is a light show, but unfortunately they weren't doing that this summer, which was kind of sad. Anyway, on to the continent of Asia.
What's the bug one though? I love these like kiosks, man. They're so well designed. Hi.
That's right.
Going to the homeland. Kind of. Home continent. Love that.
I do have to say that the attention to detail is far superior at Disney World than it is at Disneyland. Although both attract international visitors, I feel like the magnitude in which Disney World caters towards is just like 4 to 10-fold. The continent of Asia has Nepal, India, and all the minority countries that we don't usually think of when we say Asia. Don't worry, this is a little precursor to what's gonna happen later on.
Oh, it's a monkey. Just hanging around.
What are you doing?
Me? Just hanging around.
Oh, yeah!
Who is a believer of certain...
Yeah. Technically, it's compost.
Okay, I've never been to Nepal, but I don't even know where they got half of this stuff from because it looks authentic. Like, did they go and just buy a bunch of stuff that was going out of business? Were buildings decrepit and they just, like, took them? I don't know. It just seems so authentic and it's really amazing because they literally stuff every nook and cranny with items that relate to the theme and the place that we're supposed to be visiting.
Yeah, VIPs, let's go.
That Muzak though.
Oh yeah, so exotic.
I approve. Rama. And Rama and who's the chick?
I think they can afford AC.
For fans.
Curator.
Yeah, it's like a museum.
Like, I thought it was just kidding, but it really is.
Have all these things about the Yetis. Hey, it looks like our tent. Meanwhile, effort.
But that's not what they call it, okay?
Hey.
This ride was super fun. You go backwards and forwards and into other places, and it's much more scary than the Matterhorn.
That's when I'm like, oh, that was the host.
We got some explorers ready to see the Everest Mountain and Nepal. Oh, so you, oh, okay, for excess. Cool. Can you actually?
Hello, duck.
Yeah, we got a line here too.
Say hi.
Oh, sorry.
Hi.
It's
not
an oval,
it's just like a bunch
of different in and out. It's subtle. English. Yeah.
I'm thirsty enough for these secrets though.
Zing! Got a nice seat though.
It's good.
Noodle salad and ahi. Chairs.
That Disney magic, man.
I know, right? Chairs.
Actually,
the pie.
Cheers. Our first desert town.
You're 395?
Yes.
Please
don't make us get to Keto. Whoa.
I was like, the cat, the cat.
Whoa, look at this one. Oh my god. Snack at a snack.
Toilet paper, just a little extra.
Pretty real, actually. Yeah.
The line was going so fast that I couldn't appreciate what was on the ceiling here. There were like hieroglyphics of different stories from different legends that were taught to younger children. Kind of like Aesop's Fables and the fairy tales from the Grimm Brothers, which is technically what Disney is based on completely. I'm telling you, every single doorway, every wall space was taken up by some sort of beautiful memoir from the production designers' trips to the actual country, or they found similar items here in the US or on other travels, or they made it themselves. Like, look at all this climbing gear and all of the things that you can associate with adventuring and climbing Mount Everest, because I would never go, but you know, it's nice to be in the space that inspires you to pretend like you are being there.
This one, dude.
You know how we do.
Which kind of sucks, because I wanted to see it. Wow.
Because we're not down there yet. Ah! But this is a great shot because we're going up and yeah. We can see it.
Or a door. I know, because he's like not even, he's so still.
Oh, you know what he reminds me of? That lizard from Breath.
Oh my!
They're gonna be like small. Hanging around.
That's a good fruit.
They are very big on hygiene.
Flying
foxes that eat watermelon.
Bats. My name is Batty.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
I've seen
that.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
That's good.
Do an attitude right now.
He's on timeout. He's facing the wall.
Nah.
I was just kind of like, what's the thing?
Take a nap. True cat.
You know.
Exploring the ancient ruins of Animal Kingdom.
Yeah, seriously.
I don't think it's a monkey.
Fucking away.
There should be a bunch.
Hi, Chris, you don't want to try to touch the birds now, okay?
There's also those ones up there.
Oh yeah. Judging. Looking and judging.
Yeah! Spinny! Spoiler alert.
Okay, this was the last ride of the day, and the dinosaur ride literally accepted us and one other family. The reason why we got in was because the last family had this toddler that was so tired and didn't want to go, but it ended up being literally the exact ride as the Indiana Jones one, except obviously a dinosaur themed.
Last ride, guys!
Woo! Time travel commences.
I don't think he wanted to go.
I love that you can download these. I don't care if there's a watermark on them because you can still see our faces and it's all about the memories.
Ready to start jumping.
Nice. Success. Ooh. I love the decor.
So cute. Drinkware. Aw, Pride. Oh.
Yeah, well, it's because they're, you know, all the limited collection. Yeah.
150.
Okay. I like that they have stuff for the goths too. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look, and like the heads.
That's so cute.
My homeware, though, so good.
That tool. You get wet too. Because, like, the old one you used to, but this one's a real.
Warthog.
I still want to go to thing because there's.
Yeah. I think if everybody's down, I. Oh,
an area that we can. I love this umbrella situation though. It's awesome.
All right, this concludes part one of our Animal Kingdom day. Part two is going to include Disney Springs because it starts pouring for 45 minutes straight and we end up soaking in Uber just to get to the next spot. So stay tuned for that. I post every Saturday at 10 a.m. Pacific time. And until next time, keep curious, everyone. Jack out.